faith and sexuality is an issue not just for the Church in London, but the Church of England and, in fact, the wider Anglican Communion. And of course, London is a very diverse city, and I would hope that everybody can find a spiritual home and a place where they can encounter that love of God in Christ Jesus that I have. In terms of the teaching of the Church of England, it is clear about marriage, and I absolutely support that. There is a period of reflection at the moment, and for me, I am chairing one of those streams of work, and it is a time for us to reflect on our tradition and on scripture, and together to say how is it that we can offer a response that is about the inclusive love of Christ. I'm also very aware that for some, the appointment of a woman who is a bishop or a bishop who is a woman may be difficult. One of the wonderful things about London and its church is that it reflects the diversity of the Church of England. And I am very respectful of those who, for theological reasons, cannot accept my role as a priest or as a bishop. My belief is that the church diversity throughout London should flourish and should grow. Everybody should be able to find a spiritual home, and actually those that minister should minister in a way in which they do it to their best of their ability. In fact, I do believe that London could be a gift to the rest of the Church of England, to really demonstrate how unity can work and model. I have lived for over 30 years in London, lived and worked. Now, some of that, I have to admit, is south of the river, so I hope that you will forgive me for that. But my children went to school within the diocese, and therefore there is a sense for me that I am returning, and that is with great joy. I made a commitment as a teenager to follow Christ, and in the words of the hymn by Horatio Bonner, I have found in Christ my star and my sun. And that vocation and that sense of following Christ has really shaped my life. There is a sense in which he has held me firm and has enabled me to be the person that I am. And therefore it is a real privilege to be able to be in London to share what I have come to know in Christ. People will often ask me what it is like to have had two careers. First of all, as a nurse and a cancer nurse here in London, and then as the government's chief nursing officer. And then as a priest, both serving here in London in this Diocese of Southwark, then as a canon in Salisbury Cathedral, and now as a bishop. And the truth is, I feel that I have had one vocation, and that has been to follow Christ and to make him known.